Dear students, today we are going to see what are the protocols and standards. In this section, we define two widely used terms, protocols and standards. First, we will define protocol, which is synonymous with the rule. Then we discuss standards, which are agreed upon rules. Under this topic, we are going to see protocols, standards, standard organizations, and internet standards. Okay, first, what is a protocol? A protocol is a set of rules that governs data communication. That is nothing but what are the rules and regulations should be followed by a protocol. All these things will be defined with the help of a protocol. This is a topic is only a protocol is a set of rules and regulations that governs data communication. It defines what is a communicated, how it is a communicated, and when it is a communicated. All these three factors are going to take place in a protocol. The key elements of the protocols are syntax, semantics, and timings. These are the three key elements take place in a protocol. One is the syntax, one is the semantics, and another one is the timing. In syntax, the structure or format of data, meaning the order in which they are presented. That is a syntax. That is nothing but a syntax that will indicate the structure or format of the data, meaning the order in which they are presented. Next one is semantics. This refers to the meaning of each section of bits, how a particular pattern is interpreted, and what action to be taken. Like that only the semantics will be defined. Next will be timings. It refers to when data should be sent and how fast can they send in the data. Like that only syntax and semantics, timing are main things in a protocol which are going to be defined the structure and meaning of each section of bits, and the timing will be indicated with the help of the protocol. Under this protocols, after that we are going to see what are the standards should be used. The standards are essential in creating and maintaining an open and competitive market for equipment manufacturers. The standards are nothing but which are essential in creating and maintaining an open and competitive market for equipment manufacturers. Report to guarantee national and international interoperability of data and telecommunications technology and process. Because different countries are going to be used the different standards, but they should be able to communicate with the other countries also, and the report to guarantee national and international interoperability should be take place in a data communication and telecommunication technology. Under this, we are going to see the data communication standards of the two categories. One is a de facto and a de jure. And this de facto is nothing but a standards that have not been approved by an organizational body, but have been adopted through widespread use. Example, TCP/IP model. Later on, we'll see what is a TCP/IP model, how it will be communicated, what are the protocols, all these things we are going to see in a TCP/IP protocol. By de jure, this is nothing but those that have been legislated by an official regulatory body regarding this OSI ISO model. That means, example, the best example for the D0 will be OSI model. This is also will be takes place in our computer networks. Later on we will discuss what is a OSI model, all these things. The some of the standard organizations so far we are going to see in a communication network. The standard creation committees are number one, ISO, International Organization for the Standardization. The next one is ITU-P, International Telecommunication Union for Telecommunication Standards. Initially, it is known as CCITT, Consultative Committee for International Telegraphy and Telephony, and C, American National Standards Institute. IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers, EIA, Electronic Industries Association. These are the some of the standard organizations globally. We are going to recognize the different companies, ISO, IEEE, and ANSI, IEEE, and EIA. These are the standard organizations are globally recognized organizations. Next one is forums. What are the standard forums expressed globally? These forums made up of representatives from interested corporations to speed acceptance and use of new technologies in telecom industry. Day by day, the technologies are going to be improved. All these things should be, the forums should be recognized and they should be implemented and they should be accepted. Then only this will be implemented in the communication network or any network. Next one will be regulatory agencies. These regulatory agencies are nothing but the governmental agencies to protect public interest by regulating radio, TV and wire cable communications. These are the regulatory agencies that should be, if these agencies will be recognized, what are the frequencies should be used and what are the bandwidth should be used. All these things will be regulated by the, with the help of the regulatory agencies which are going to be implement the rules and regulations. Next, the internet standard. The internet standards is a thoroughly tested specifications used by those who work with the internet. That means if anything will be implemented in the internet standard, that should be thoroughly tested, the specifications, then they should be implemented. If the specifications begins with the internet track, working document with no official status and 6 months lifetime. Upon recommendation from the internet authorities, a draft may be published as a request for comment that will be updated at the RFC. These are the internet standards which are going to take place